There are a variety of shapes you can place in your LibreOffice document. I have here basic shapes, symbol shapes, block arrows, flowchart, callouts, stars and banners. And I got all these from down below here. You see the basic shapes, symbols, block arrows, flowcharts, callouts, and stars. How I got the toolbars pulled away was we click this down arrow and grab at the bottom. We pull it off. We see that one disappears. And we can place our toolbar anywhere we like on the screen. If we go under View, Toolbars, Rectangles, we're adding even more shapes out there. And we can add more shapes up on our toolbar. This is the one I created earlier. It doesn't have to be the customized. You can add them on any toolbar. Clicking Add. Going down to the Drawing category. We have Circle Arc. We can add that. Circle Pie. And there are other shapes as well that are not on the other toolbars. I'm going to turn on the Options toolbar under View, Toolbars, Options. And we've seen this toolbar in an earlier tutorial. Let's go over how to place an object on the screen. I'm going to click on a rectangle. And I've got my upper left-hand corner positioning and my lower right. I can make it thinner or shorter. And if I hold down Shift, it becomes a square. And this all will work until I let go of the left mouse. Once I let go of the left mouse, that position is there. I can stretch out the object on the side and bottom, or on the corner. I can do it in any direction. If I hold down Shift, when I pull at any of the handles, it makes the shape shrink or grow. Let's add another shape. This time, I'm going to select an unfilled rectangle. If I hold down Alt, we'll notice that instead of the upper left hand to the upper right hand corner, it's created from the center. It's also jumping kind of funny. I don't have the snap to grid on, but since I'm holding down Alt, it snaps to the grid. And remember, I changed my grid to have 1 inch spacing from side to side and a half inch from top to bottom. So that's why I was jumping kind of oddly. Now I'll turn on the snap to grid, create another unfilled rectangle, and we'll see that it grows from the center, and I can make it wider or thinner, and if I hold down Shift as well, it grows from the center and makes a square. Now let me turn off the snap to grid and the grid itself. And to move it, we click on it. When we have the four-sided arrow, we can move it around in any direction. But let's say we only want to move it to the left or the right. If I hold down Shift, now I can move it to the left without it moving up and down. Or I can move it up and down without it going to the side. See, when I move my cursor to the right, it still says up and down. We can also go on a 45-degree angle. So if you want to add some constraints to your movement, hold down Shift. Now you'll see when I go over one of these unfilled rectangles, when I click on it, it doesn't select. I need to be right on the line to select it, which can be tricky at times. So the other way is just to select it with our arrow, and that may be a little easier than trying to click right on the line. And we can also move this with our arrow keys, up and down, left and right. I want to go over the Alt features one more time to make sure that we have them all down. If we hold down Alt when we start a shape, it creates the shape from the center. If I'm moving a shape around the screen, then I hold down Alt, it locks in to the grid. If the grid is off, or it will move it freely if the grid is on, does the opposite. Now, if I have the four-sided arrow and holding down the mouse button, then I press Alt before I start moving it, It now allows me to make a copy of that shape, and I'm moving my cursor where I want to place the copy.